This evening, I'm going to talk about Boxplot, one of the amazing tools in quality control. Boxplot is also used for exploratory data analysis. Okay, let's say we have a data set. For example, this is our data set. Now, I need to know what's the minimum value, what's the maximum value of this data set. So, if I draw a box plot of this particular data set, it will give me the maximum value, minimum value and everything else. So we can see this is the minimum value and this is the maximum value and this is the median. We will see all of the definitions momentarily. So this is our box plot for this data set. Now let's move on to the theory. Outlier is the data point that tells lie about the data set. From the box plot, we know the minimum value, this data point here, and then the first quartile. So basically the first quartile is first 25% of the data set, and then interquartile range. So let's go back to our data set. So here, for this particular figure, if we can see, this blue area is the interquartile range. So for our data set, we have total 5 data point, I guess. We have total 5 data point. And of course, this is the median value. And this point is the maximum value of the data. So in our case, 40 is the maximum data point. So you can see, from boxplot, we can visualize the data point more easily compared to the dataset by itself. So first application of boxplot is comparing the data with other data in the dataset. For example, we know this data point is below the median value. Okay, let's say I'm taking quality control class. Now, my student's guardian, one of my student's guardian is asking me how's my child is doing in your course. So in that case, assuming that that particular student is getting this mark, maybe 4 or 5, and some other students are getting maybe 40 or something, like our previous data. So assuming this is the class test mark. So if we assume this is the class test mark, and that student, like the student's guardian who is asking me, that student is getting 2. So I would say, your child is performing below the maximum students in the class. And of course, another application of boxplot is detecting the outliers. Okay, viewers, now let's move on to Six Sigma questions. In Six Sigma, and particularly in Six Sigma yellow belt and green belt, these type of questions are pretty common. Here we go. The first question is, boxplot graph is used to something. As of now, we know boxplot graph can detect the outliers, right? So point number one is correct. Then differentiate before and after improvements. Yes, this is also correct, because if we see the boxplot graph, for example, this boxplot is used to check the performance of a system before improvement, and another box plot graph is drawn to check the system after improvement. So yes, we can check the system before and after improvement by box plot graph. Second question, you are a project manager wanting to compare on time delivery. Okay, now we are going to compare three teams, right? So in this case also, we can apply boxplot. For example, the performance, say, we don't know, maybe, say, for example, for this particular problem, compare on-time delivery percentage. So, for example, team 1, their performance is 4, and team 2, their performance is 4 point something. So, team 2's performance is better compared to team 1 and team 3. We are just assuming the graph. This is not the original graph. Third question. What kind of graph would help us to analyze stability of a non-parametric distribution? Non-parametric distribution. This means basically we assume nothing, no assumption about the distribution. We have no assumption of the distribution. In that case, yes, box plot graph. Because all other three, they are control charts. And we know for control charts, we assume some sort of distribution for the dataset. The last question for today's video. The distance between Q1 and Q3. Q3 and Q1. So this distance. So this is interquartile range. Interquartile range. It helps to understand something of the process variation. Understanding the width. This one. It understands the width of the process variation. So answer is 1. Interquartile range and width.